And now to our top story. More changes are in store for the troubled Alisal Union School District. Action News has learned the district may be facing even more sanctions by the state. This just weeks after a trustee was assigned to oversee the district that has persistently failed to meet state standards. With more on the district's troubles, Action News reporter Felix Cortez joins us live in Salinas.
Well, Aaron, the academically troubled school district will again be under the microscope at the state capitol tomorrow, and this time the sanctions could be tougher.
One thing we like is spring break. Oh, yeah.
Some might say Rich Rodriguez epitomizes what's wrong with the Alisal Union School District. He pulled his fourth grader out of the district because he felt the curriculum was below her learning level.
Unfortunately, this is what's happened to the school, and we've heard from a lot of parents that their kids do go to these schools, and if they could, they'd get out.
Parents may soon have that option should the district be hit with more state sanctions. One of them would allow students to transfer out of the district. On Tuesday, state educators will take another look at the troubled district and could implement more sanctions, like removing schools from the district, restructuring or abolishing the district altogether. The state could even decide to withhold funds.
And it's just a sad thing that the Alisal School District is where they're at. Just too good of a area and nice schools and stuff to be suffering like that. And the ones that are suffering are the kids.
Earlier this month, the State Board of Education decided to appoint a trustee to oversee the district. That person will have veto power over all decisions made by the Alisal School Board. But since then, the district has booted Superintendent Esperanza Zendejas and replaced her with John Ramirez. But is that enough to prevent more sanctions?
We're hoping they can turn it around.
Well, before state educators implement any new sanctions, they will, of course, look at what the Alisal School Board has done to improve the failing school district. And, of course, one major decision that they made was to replace the superintendent. And then one board member has resigned, Gary Carnes. But again, the question is that enough? And that is something the state school board will be looking at tomorrow when it meets at 5 o'clock in the evening at the state capitol.
But Felix, you know, we have covered the Alisal School District extensively. And as you know, it's not just the education. It does seem that the board is in chaos, that there really isn't anyone that has sort of taken charge of this district. Do you think it may be a case of a little too little too late?
Well, I mean, those are some points that people who have packed the school board meetings have brought up. We've all heard about the chaos at the school board meetings, sometimes the intimidation. This is all stuff that the state educators will be looking at. And part of the sanctions that they could implement includes removing people from the school district who are responsible for the failure. We've already seen the action that the school board has taken, but the state education department could go even further than that and come in and start removing people on their own. So is it too little too late? Maybe, but at least the state is involved now, and some people will say that's a good sign.
All right, Felix, thank you. State educators will again be visiting the Alisal Union School District, and this time they do want to hear from parents. A public meeting has been planned for April 14th. The time and location has yet to be announced when it is. We will certainly bring you that information.